Carpooling. They say it's one of the best ways you can save money. Instead of taking two cars, three cars, four cars, just huddle up everyone in a car and it saves some money. Now, that's great and all in real life, but what can this teach us on the blockchain? Well, this can teach us that batching transactions can actually save money on the main chain. So in today's KuCoin DigiDive, we're going to be talking about Optimism and the OP token. If you guys would like to get started trading with this token, there's a link in the description below that will give you 20% off trading fees, baby. So before we show all the fancy visuals, the cool website, and go into some other things, and even mention the airdrop, what is an optimistic rollup? Well, this is the technology that Optimism is built on. This is basically known as a fancy way of saying, hey, look, this is a blockchain that piggybacks security off of another chain. So in this case, this would be the parent chain, would be Ethereum. So you have the optimistic rollup that is able to function, do transactions, do all this, that, and this, but it doesn't have security on the chain. This is actually taking advantage of the Ethereum network security. So how the block execution works is it's a first come, first serve basis. So once you bridge onto Optimism, transaction speeds are almost instant. It's crazy how fast these are. It's a first in, first out. There's no mempool. So there's no, like, you put in 5 Gwei and the current going rate is like 100 Gwei and you're sitting there waiting weeks and weeks just for your transaction to go through. Yes, this is a legit thing. Some people put in too low gas and their transaction is stuck in the mempool for like ever. Yes, you can speed up the gas, but some people don't understand how to do that. So on Optimism, transactions are either instantly accepted or instantly rejected. So with our day and time, nobody has patience anyways. So this is pretty saucy. Now, when you send that transaction, this is not going to the Ethereum main chain directly. This is actually going to a sequencer. This sequencer is broadcasting the group of transactions that were just placed onto the main chain. This is why I gave the example of carpooling. Instead of sending like 10, 20 different cars to go to one different place, what if you huddled everyone into one car? Each person would represent each and every transaction. The car would represent the transaction or the total transactions that was submitted to the main chain. And each person would represent their own. That's why I gave the example of carpooling. So instead of 20 people driving a car and wasting gas in 20 cars, you just have everyone inside one car and boom, done. Everyone's there. And everyone shares the cost and the expense for gas. If you want to learn more about the tech, I'll leave a link in the description below that will give you access to the docs. All right, so let's go ahead and show some fancy colors and some fancy stuff. This is the Optimism bridge. This is where you can bridge from Ethereum to Optimism. Bear in mind, it's instantly to bridge, or just about instant. It's the time of the Ethereum transaction to confirm and show up on Optimism. But when you're going from Optimism to Ethereum, keep in mind there is a 7-day challenge period. This is mainly for those who are just, I don't know, doing some funny business, some double spin, all kinds of garbage. There are other bridges that you can use if you don't want to wait the 7 days. These are like Seller Bridge or any swap bridge. So there's multiple bridges out there, so you can check them all out. So the TLDR on Optimism, it's basically everything you know and love on Ethereum, but the transaction speeds are faster. And well, they don't have as many dApps as Ethereum has currently. There are a lot of the main dApps bridging over on Optimism. Some, just to name a few, are like Uniswap, you got Dodo, you got Synthetics. Now, those aren't the only ones. There are many more, but just wanted to get the point across that it's just a cheaper and much faster Ethereum experience. So let's go and get into this Optimism token. The OP token is actually being airdropped to several different users. And here's the breakdown right here. 19% of the initial OP token supply is reserved for user airdrops. 5% will be distributed on airdrop number one. 14% will be for future airdrops. So if you miss the first airdrop, there are some other airdrops coming. 25% will be given as proactive project funding. So this is to bring other people over and say, hey, look, come check us out. Come build over here. Do this junk. This is fun. Another 20% is given as inflation towards retroactive public goods funding. 19% is given as the initial token supply allocated to core contributors, and 17% allocated to investors. Here's the overview of how the governance will work. The token house, this is going to be the people who hold the OP token. This is going to be for project incentives, protocol upgrades, treasury funds. The OP token is going to be governing over this. Then you have the Citizens House. This is the retroactive public goods funding. These are going to be issued through soul-bound tokens. These type of NFTs are non-transferable, so they aren't like a normal NFT. These are ones that can be like you graduate from college and get issued a degree. This degree would be stuck on that wallet address, that type of thing. That's what a soul-bound NFT is. So it's an NFT that's not transferable. So these people would be elected and they can't transfer it to someone else and it can't simply be sold. So it's pretty cool and it's an interesting idea. Now, overall, both of these guys will be governing and deciding on network parameters and granting citizenships. So almost like a regular democracy. So if you guys want to check to see if you potentially got an airdrop or if you got the airdrop, make sure you guys check out Optimism's main website and connect your DeFi wallet. Overall, what are my closing thoughts on the project in general? Well, I really like Optimism. I like the technology. I like what they're doing. But as for the OP token, it is mainly used for governance. So if the success of the Optimism community does extremely well and a lot of projects start building over there, some people may see some value in governing over a project like that. Outside of bribes, I don't see a token value accrual mechanism for the OP token. So in general, time will tell. We'll see what happens. Hit you with that wisdom one-liner. Proverbs chapter 14, verses 18. The simple inherit folly, but the prudent are crowned with knowledge. Be thoughtful in what you do, guys. If you guys would like to get started trading with this coin, there's a link in the description below that will give you 20% off trading fees. And if you guys would like to see some of our previous videos, there's one here, 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 and like there.